Hello and welcome. Perhaps you're working with Ethan from the character package from the third person character of Unity and you want to change him a bit. Welp, how about changing the textures? I already showed you how to change the model. Weird huge hand, but I'm happy it worked. Right, so now let us change the texture. You can see Ethan Gray and Ethan White exists in third person character. Let's click on them and see they just use an albedo color, but we want to use a texture. So let's see, where is this occlusion mask? It's located in textures. What we're gonna do is open this in GIMP, so let's just open the Show in Explorer thing, and I'm gonna bring up GIMP. And I'm gonna drag an Ethan occlusion, and the first thing I'm gonna do is to reduce the file size, or rather the resolution. So I'm gonna right click, go to image, and scale image, and this crazy resolution I'm gonna set to 512, just so we can work quickly. You might want to set it to 1024 if you're actually going to use it, but if it's just a test, 512 more than enough. Alright, this is a much better size, so let's export this, Ctrl+Shift+E, and I'm going to use the JPEG format, very important. And this will be Ethan Diffuse, and enter, and enter. Alright, so now I can just press Ctrl+E, and it will re-export. So, to give this some color, I'm just going to create a new layer. For that, in the Layers tab, I'm going to press on this button, and just press OK. I'm going to use the pen tool using N or this icon, and I'm going to zoom in and let's first up make his top a bit colorful. So let's paint it. Let's select the color here. Let's make it just red. I'm just going to click here and then I'm going to hold down Shift and continue clicking so that it just follows. And don't worry, we're on a new layer so we don't destroy the underlying info. Alright, now that I've finished this shape, I'm gonna use Shift+B or the bucket tool, or I can press this icon, color fill. I'm gonna click in here. Okay, for some reason it was set to background color fill, let's set it to foreground. There we go. Back to the pen tool, and let's just change this mode from opacity to Luma Darken Only. Let's use Luma Darken Only. And now I'm going to set the opacity to, let's say, 75. All right, we're going to change the color. Let's give them some blue pants and paint them blue here. Again with the shape. All right, and we don't have to finish because the red borders, so we can use the fill tool again. Let's just export this for a quick test. Ctrl+E, and it's done. And in here we're just going to press Ctrl+R for loading, and here's the image file. So now we need to access a material. Let's go back to the materials folder. Ethan White, we're just going to drag this on this model, by the way. And now we're going to change the albedo image with this circle here. And we're going to pick Ethan Diffuse. There it goes. And here he is in action. And we can just continue. Let's give him some green hair, I say. Where is this hair anyway? I think it's this. Let's hope that's all. Refresh. Yep, that worked pretty much. And let's give him some skin. There we go. I think I missed some of that hair. And exporting and refreshing. And we don't see anything behind the shades anyways. Oh. Looks like we didn't get all of it. So there's much more hair here, actually. My bad. Fixing that, exporting and testing. There we go. I'm not sure what this might be. Let's try a new fresh color. Weird, yellow doesn't work that well. Let's try anyways. Alright, looks like it was the sleeves. Instead I'm gonna fill this with something pinkish. Yeah, I prefer that. Maybe some purple for the gloves. You know, we just want it to be very colorful and very noticeable so we can see our changes immediately. Just gonna fill the rest. And great. Oh yeah, look at that big hand. And finally, green shoes, of course. Now, kind of turquoise. Here they are. And fill. And I think I'm just gonna pick one color for everything else. Let's go with some kind of grayish blue. And filling all the remaining gaps. Alright, he's fully dressed. So this is how easy you can skin. So this is how easy you can change the look of Ethan. You know what, we're gonna also get rid of that logo here. Sorry buddy, but it has to go. So let me just use the pen tool. I'm gonna dip the color in here. Actually, I'm gonna go to the other layer. Get the color there and just make it white. And export. And refresh. Okay, that didn't help much. So we need to actually edit this. Oh, the huge resolution. So let's zoom in on that. Get the color. Maybe also the smudge tool. Yeah, yeah. Getting rid of all that. Can't have no affiliation with Unity, come on. Neo Code. Pretty cool game. They actually kept this logo in there. I don't think Unity really wants that, do they now? Pretty sure it's under the standard terms that allows using it in any kind of game. Alright, so this is done. Let me just export it with Control E and export. Now this one is taking forever because it's so freaking huge. Alright, anyways, let's refresh again. Oh yeah, of course. And the freaking normal, we have to edit that one as well. Where is that? Oh, there you are. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. I think I'm gonna use the clone tool here. And we're getting rid of it. Okay, let's hope this is not a huge mess. Let's just export it as it is. And Control E and export and replace. And export, and it's again taking a while because it's a huge file. Alright, back to Unity, refresh. And it's, come on, it's gone. You can kind of see how I removed it there, but it's better now. Alright, I hope this helped. Make sure to subscribe to see my next Unity editing video for beginners. Give this video a like if it helped. If you still have problems, let me know in the comments. And apart from that, his spiky hair is going through his glasses. And I hope to see you in the next video. Until then, ciao.